How will Texas fare in the SEC? Welcome to the Voice of College Football. Please like the video, share the videos out on social media, and please subscribe right here at the Voice of College Football. We discuss, debate, and analyze college football every day with you. Call in shows and live streams throughout the week. Jump on in. All right, Texas and the SEC. We addressed Oklahoma's move to the SEC, the Sooners' past performance against the SEC, and what it might project to going forward. We will now do the same with Texas. Let's look at the results, recent results, and then look at what this probably means for Texas football going forward in regards to wins and losses on the field. All right. Texas's most recent game against the SEC was actually a pretty impressive performance at home in 2019 against LSU. At the time of kickoff, it appeared as though this was an even matchup. Texas was a slight underdog at home. LSU coming off a 10-3 season under Joe Burrow at quarterback. Of course, we know what happened with LSU. They faced one of the tougher schedules in recent college football memory. They lambasted just about everyone. They went 15-0 and won the national championship. They won a close game in Austin against Texas. It was a seesaw battle in which LSU typically had the upper hand with a one-score lead. Typically, but it was down to the wire to a certain extent. LSU did lead by two scores in the fourth quarter. Texas cut it to 45-38, and that was the final score. That LSU team was an all-time great team. Texas finished 8-5, number 25 in the country. So a good showing for the Horns against an SEC elite. All right, in 2018, of course, Texas was a huge underdog at the Sugar Bowl against a Georgia team that thought it should have been in the college football playoff, had blown a 2-touchdown lead against Alabama in the SEC championship game. Georgia, Texas, the Bulldogs missing some players. Texas wins it 28-21 to finish at 10-4. That team went to the Big 12 championship game where they had earlier beaten Oklahoma, lost to the Sooners in the rematch, finished number 9 in the country. Despite the Texas win, Georgia still held them off in the polls at number 7 at 11-3. Texas with a big win over Georgia in the Sugar Bowl of 2018/19. In the previous bowl season, you had Texas under Tom Herman in his first season taking on Mizzou. Texas, a slight underdog, was convincing in its win against the Tigers 33-16 in the Texas Bowl. That Mizzou team finished at 7-6. Texas at 6-6, won the bowl game, of course, at 7-6. Again, Tom Herman's first team at Texas finished on a high note against the SEC. Go back to 2014. Charlie Strong against Brett Bielema, Arkansas on the come up at that point before the downfall. Arkansas finished at 7-6 after blowing out Texas 31-7 at the Texas Bowl, and another disappointing Charlie Strong season finished at 6-7. All right, in 2013, you had Texas and Ole Miss playing a home-and-home series in 2012 and 13. In the 13 game, Ole Miss won at 44-23 in Austin. That Ole Miss team finished at 8-5, Texas at 8-5 as well. Bad loss for Texas. They're taking on a like-seeded team, and they got trounced 44-23 at home. The previous season, good win for Texas against Ole Miss. 66-31 in that game. Ole Miss finished at 7-6. That Texas team at 9-4 under Mack Brown finished number 19 in the country. The two previous Texas matchups against the SEC, you had a national championship game, of course, at the Rose Bowl, the BCS championship game. Colt McCoy went down early. There's much speculation as to what would have happened. Of course, Colt McCoy was one of the best quarterbacks in the country. Texas was a one-loss team. Alabama undefeated. Crimson Tide won it 37-21. They marched out to a big lead. Texas cut it to 24-21 in the fourth quarter. Alabama laid on the defense late and scored 37-21 Bama in the national championship game of 09. In the 03 Cotton Bowl, LSU and Texas, Longhorns won it over the Tigers 35-20. So since the year 2000, Texas 6-5 against the SEC. All right, let's look at Texas since 2010. Again, BCS championship game appearance in 09, losing to Alabama. Starting in 2010 under Mack Brown and then transitioning to Charlie Strong, And then Tom Herman, now Steve Sarkisian. We'll see what he has in store against a tougher SEC than what he would have faced in the Big 12. Texas, since 2010, is 78-61 overall. Break down the numbers. Basically, that's going 7-6 every season. Almost exactly. 7.8 wins per year, 6.1 losses. 78-61 for Texas since 2010. In the Big 12, Texas is 52-46. 52-46. They're basically going 5-4. Not even quite 5-4 average season in the Big 12. How does that relate to the and convert transition into the SEC? I see it this way. We looked at Oklahoma. Oklahoma has been an elite football program, transitioning, losing 0-1 games typically in the Big 12 would transition into, okay, they're going to play a more difficult schedule, but there's only so many teams in the SEC that can match Oklahoma, but you go through that grind and Oklahoma is going to get upset more often in the SEC. So you're going to have to watch the video, but we projected what the record will be in the SEC versus what it's been in the Big 12. We will do the same thing with Texas. Follow this logic. So Texas in the Big 12 faces, in a typical year, 2 to 3 to 4 games that are locks. They're gimmies. They're wins. Okay. They also face 1 or 2 opponents that most likely they're going to lose to. Oklahoma and a few others, even though they've played the Sooners close in that rivalry game. Most seasons, it's been a one-score game. But Texas being what they've been, which is just barely a 500 ball club over the past 11 seasons, only plays 1 or 2 locks and then 1 or 2 almost assured losses. So they're playing a bunch of toss-up games. And they're basically splitting those games is what's happening. They're basically splitting those games against the likes of West Virginia and TCU on down the line. I know that they've not played well against TCU, but I'm saying against the collection, the majority of the Big 12. If you take out Kansas on the bottom end and Iowa State pre-Matt Campbell, Texas Tech on most seasons, and then you take out the upper echelon, which has been basically Oklahoma, and maybe if somebody else jumps up, Texas is splitting against the rest of the Big 12. You convert that to the SEC, Texas is going to face far less games that are give-me's. Arkansas, since they've been horrible the last few seasons prior to 2020, that's an example right there. Maybe currently a South Carolina, Vanderbilt most of the time. But less give-me's for Texas, 1 or 2 a year max. On the top end, though, there are going to be more certain losses. Unless Texas improves considerably. Talking about Texas in their current state, and we have yet to see what Steve Sarkisian can bring to the table. Even with top 5 to 10 recruiting classes, it's been a struggle in the Big 12. Okay, against the SEC, that almost certain loss, probable loss, is going to increase where it was 1 or 2 in the Big 12. It's going to go to 3 or 4. And then even the toss-up games, if there are 3 to 5 toss-up games per season in the SEC for Texas, less of those are going to go Texas's way. Texas, again, since 2010, is 52-46. That's almost exactly a 5-4 record, even less than that in the Big 12. If they lose 2 more games in the SEC per season, and that's reasonable in a 9-game SEC season, lose 2 more games in the SEC on average per season, they're suddenly going from 52-46 in conference play to 30-68. That 5-4 becomes 3-6 most of the time. Unless they can improve based on talent, resources, recruiting footprint under Steve Sarkisian. Our thoughts on Texas football going forward in the SEC, leave your comments below right here at the Voice of College Football.